στιγμή, διαφίλε.
2 years ago, you were watching your team playing a semi-final. Tough feeling. Yes. What's the feeling today by winning again?
It's a great feeling. Great feeling for the club, for the people who believed in me, gave me a chance, and for my teammates. I mean, this win tonight proves that all year we've been fighting, and we had a good feeling in this team. This team has good heart, good character, and good guys. And, you know, tonight our back was against the wall, fourth quarter, and played 30 minutes of not so good basketball, but in the fourth quarter, we came together, got some stops, we talked to each other, we fought, and this was most important for tonight's game.
When you were down 14 points, yeah, and you were sitting at the bench, mm-hmm, before you switched the defense, you know, what was your thoughts, honestly?
Please, coach, give me a chance to go out there. I was praying.
How you said it.
Yes, I wanted a chance to go out and at least, you know, put the game in rough it up a little bit, you know, go up and D up and, you know, have him feel my body. Even if I had to fall out, I didn't care, but coach gave me a chance. We cut it to 8. We started seeing that they were a little shaky. So I started talking to the guys to believe, and we got some stops. We got made some great plays down the stretch. But honestly, you know, the defense and believing each other, and from one guy to the guy, the manager, whoever, yeah, you know, everybody believed, and it's good for us.
Daniel, the fact that you won this year 3 times in a row against Real Madrid proves that, you know, you were the only team that matched too good, you know, with the European champion.
I mean, it's difficult to say, but, you know, you gotta take the facts. Facts is that we went to Madrid and beat them. They came to Moscow and lost, so beat them again, and tonight we gave them another punch, and, you know, it's a proof. So we just gotta stay humble, get it together, and get ready for Sunday night.
It seems that, you know, in this court, you know, and also around Baskonia, you know, you found, you know, some rhythm in the series. When you lost in Moscow, you came here, you won 2 games in a row, coming from behind, 12 points in the fourth game, and tonight the same, 14 points.
We did it twice with Baskonia. Last game of the regular season also, we were down 14 in the fourth, came back. Baskonia was a tremendous series, difficult for us. They really tested us, but, you know, we even through a difficult time, leaving Moscow 1-1, we had to come together and, you know, look at each other in the face and understand that we had to come in here and do the job. And now we're here and feel comfortable in this arena.
Let's go one step further to the final. You see what kind of performance Larkin and Mrs. had. So how you plan to stop them?
We will see. I mean, it's obviously we will have a game plan for them. They are scoring the ball with lots of freedom. They're shooting threes. They seems like they're playing very, very easily right now. So we got a big task ahead. We got to focus, stay humble, get some rest, and go back to our routine and take care of business.
Last one, you are the only guy in the world that you can make Olympiacos fans to root for CSKA in the final.
I'm happy about that.
So
man,
can you have a message for them?
I'm happy about
we don't know
that.
If they play against Panathinaikos on Monday. You know what happens in Greece.
Keep pushing and stay positive for the goals of Greek basketball. I know it's not the best moment, but sometimes you gotta look over and see what's really important. Love of the game. There's a lot of young kids watching, and it's bad when it gets to politics. But I don't want to get into that.
Yeah, yeah.
I just hope that things get better for everybody in Greece. And say hi to Alo. I miss them.
Congratulations. Okay, guys.